Writing my blockbusting memoirs always makes me hungry, but a trip to the kitchen would disrupt my creative flow and disappoint readers across the globe.
So can a machine help me cook my favorite food while I maintain my creative flow? Because I really do love sausages. My sausage-sizzling solution lies in the hands of my semi-finalists.
There's always time for a cup of tea.
The aviators are plucky amateur pilots.
Well, we're always feeling confident. It doesn't mean we'll succeed, but we're feeling good.
And social mediocrity are superstars on something called TikTok.
Test it, test it, test it.
Ooh, that's a new one.
The victor will face the winner of the first semi, the brilliant Fieldhouse brothers, in the final.
Oh, come on!
Getting to the final would be a little bit mind-blowing, but I sort of think it's possible all of a sudden now.
As ever, the battle will take place in one of my many outbuildings.
I may be eccentric, but I'm not completely mad. I'm not letting them in here.
Instead, each team has a workshop packed with objects to use in their contraptions.
Like again, huh?
Here we are again.
We are hoping to keep our workshop a little bit cleaner this time.
And 3 days to create machines that start in my study, cross the hallway, and finish when sausages hit pan in the kitchen. After the typewriter detonates a balloon, they want a weight to switch on a leaf blower, which floats a brolly to pop another balloon, releasing a plane on a zip wire to burst a third balloon that drops a boot and sends a bowling ball down a ramp. From there, the aviators are winging it. The football from the study will knock skittles, starting a train set that topples cups, that hits the controller of a flying drone, that tips a seesaw, that makes a sewing machine pull cloth, opening an umbrella, knocking a guitar, that releases a banner, sending a bucket of goo into the next room. Obviously. They want a seesaw to fire Albert's gun, to knock over cups, which switch on Paul's mincer, winding a string that tips a bucket to turn on Steve's kettle, steaming some kitchen roll that drops a bucket, pulling a string that shuts the fridge and starts a firework, making a digger drop my sausages into the pan. But there's no egg whisk yet. They'll be hoping that the typewriter will trigger the explosives to start the leaf blower to raise the umbrella, releasing the plane to send the bowling ball to fire the stomp rocket and release the arrow that hits the target to start the tether ball, sending the football into the hallway. Fingers crossed. They're hoping skittles start the train that knocks over the cups to launch the drone, tipping the seesaw to start the sewing machine that drops the weight to trigger the umbrella and topple the guitar, unfurling the banner to send the bucket of goo onto its latch. Hoping Albert's gun topples cups that start a grinder, winding a string that tips a basket that drops balls onto the switch for a kettle, that steams kitchen roll to drop a pot that shuts a fridge, turning the whisk that starts a firework and chain fountain, making a traffic cone knock a toy digger, sending my sausages into the pan. They'll only get this far, though, if they've made their first two rooms work perfectly.
Zach, you're a fan of testing. What do you think?
I think it needed to be tested more. Yeah. But, I mean, it's definitely the longest machine that we've ever seen. And it's, you know, it's really beautiful and whimsical. So I have my fingers crossed, but I can't call it because I don't know.
There is a lot to go wrong in your own time. Start your machine in its entirety for the first time. Good luck.
Albert, take it away.
So the tether ball's going, so nice, real nice time delay.
So quick, bang, 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 and then a good, graceful moment.
Nice, slow, so they're going into the next room.
Oh, train.
The train did not start.
You can intervene, Albert, you can intervene and start the train.
Manually releasing the train is the first of 3 interventions they can make under Zach's rules.
Okay, so now the sewing machine is sucking it through, yeah.
Work.
I love the umbrella.
I love the umbrella. We're into the next room.
Viscosity.
Wow.
Okay, now the meat grinder's going. That's winding the string. It's going to drop the bucket. And so now that's switched on the tea kettle.
They call it a napkin bridge.
Yeah, and it just will break that, allowing that bucket to fall. There it goes.
Wow.
You did it. You are there. You are there. One intervention and another million transitions.
This chaotic machine was packed with references to the hobby they all share. Used fluid motion and the egg whisk, and safely delivered my sausages. The only fly in the ointment is the train set, which needed an intervention. Iron Man's stunt double is hoping a typewriter releases Tony, who rolls a globe that knocks a plant pot, triggering a truck to strike matches that burn a string, dropping a weight that turns on a fan that blows a sail into the next room. Okay, the fan from the kitchen pulls a pin, releasing an ET-inspired bike to fly and pull a card from a funnel that releases marbles into a homemade Archimedes screw that should transport them uphill. They're hoping the looping car hits a fishing net, tipping a puzzle cube that's magically solved down a ramp, hitting a mannequin's hand that pulls a skateboard off a shelf, that starts a chain fountain, pulling a pin that sends a second car into the next room. They want Josh's car from the hallway to trigger a rat trap that starts Mike's extravagant dining table ball run that hits a mouse trap, releasing a spoon that's lifted by Baz's balloons to tension a string that releases the flying sausage dropper. The only thing missing is an egg whisk. They want the typewriter to set Tony swinging, rolling the globe to knock the plant and drop the book, yanking the truck to light the matches that burn the rope, dropping the weight that triggers the fan to blow the sail into the next room. The bike should release marbles into Mike's Archimedes screw, dropping them into the gutter where bubble bath might be tipped into a pot that triggers Josh's toy car and puzzle cube, releasing a chain fountain that sends another toy car into the kitchen. They want Josh's hallway car to hit a rat trap, triggering the egg whisk that starts Mike's dining table ball run extravaganza, hitting a mouse trap to release balloons, which should rise up a string and send Baz's sausage dropper down a line to release its cargo into the pan. Josh spent all day checking the first two rooms, so we'll be desperate it works all the way through.
Right. Zach, they were under pressure for time today, but they got it finished.
Yeah, I mean, they matched their style all throughout.
Yeah.
And you know what? I know room one and two will work because, well, Josh tested it all day.
No pressure.
No pressure at all. Room three, you know what? I have my hopes. They have great luck on their side as well, so.
We all want to see it all work. In your own time, when you're ready, start your machine in its entirety.
All right, kid.
Here we go.
Go on, Tony.
Lovely slow start with the Tony. It's like, there it goes.
Oh, slow. Oh, I thought they hadn't lit then.
As long as it goes through it.
Okay.
I love all the time delays, just from the get-go. And the fan.
So all that's got to do is turn and we're into the next room.
Yep. Drops, hits the rack.
Well, you're in.
Oh, the E-T's so classy. The Archimedes screw.
So now we wait.
Oh, it's done it. It's done it. It's done it. We'd be on. Oh, my word.
That was so much faster than yesterday.
Yeah, go. Wait, it's going to go. It's going to go. Go on.
You are through.
I'm out.
And?
Anyone else going on? Because I don't.
Oh, it's derailed.
No.
Oh.
Gut-wrenching. The string didn't release the spoon handle.
Oh. Intervention. You can intervene.
Oh, no.
So Mike's made the first of the three interventions he's allowed.
I've never seen this before. This is magical.
Nobody's ever seen it. It's never been run.
And intervention number two, the sausage dropper is stuck.
Oh, yes, touch it again.
Oh.
Boom! Sausages. Well done, team!
The machine got off to a brilliant start, with fluid motion working perfectly. Then the simplest detail of Mike's dining table extravaganza let them down, and Baz's floating balloons didn't quite have the force to release his sausage dropper. But what a spectacle!
I'd only just realised when I watched the aviators run the whole of their machine how much of it was to do with flight. The umbrella that just lifted off, was a bow and arrow firing through the air, a plane going through there, a lot of stuff, a helicopter that took off.
They were true to their name, they kept to a theme. I think they had a fantastic machine all throughout.
But to be fair, also on the other side, social mediocrity, great cartoon elements, and that's what I want to see.
Right, the E.T. bike. How fantastic is that? Slow, just suspenseful, beautiful.
So you've got to do your sums and do your thinking. Do you have a winner?
I do have a winner in mind this time.
Okay, right.
Congratulations both teams for getting to the semi-final and for building exactly the kind of machines we want to see at this level. They're fun, creative, complex, chaotic, and clever. Sadly, it will be only one team going forward to the finals, and that team is going to be... It's the Aviators. Well done, both teams.
Congratulations.
Yeah, we're proud of what we've done. We've done, I think we've done well, haven't we?
They're good guys.
I definitely don't feel cheated.
No.
No, not in the slightest.
Oh, the best team won, definitely.
Next stop for the Aviators is the final.
Let's see what happens. I don't know. I'm a bit more nervous than all else. How are you?
I'm full of beer.
Beer be good.
Yeah. I might go for a rum and coke. I've had a lot of tea.
Next time, it is the final.
Find the problem, solve the problem.
Aviators versus Fieldhouse Brothers.
You can all set up, no matter, you know.
In an epic party-throwing showdown.